I ain't doing so good.
Then maybe you can take pity on my plight. Please, it won't take long. Maybe I can help you with that cough.
Sir! I'm glad I caught you, sir.
Captain Monroe, do you know my friend, Mr. Morgan?
No, sir. I don't have the pleasure.
Arthur Morgan.
It's an honor, sir.
How can I help you, Captain?
I was just in Saint-Denis. I spoke with the mayor. It's not good news, I'm afraid. May I ride with you for a little?
Of course.
Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a site up in the mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing. What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint-Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose there's much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe.
Sure, I can help.
That's good news. Thank you. Come meet me on the reservation whenever you can. I'm sorry to be forward, but there's so much to be done. Anyway, gentlemen, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you both soon.
Sure.
Thank you, Captain.
Enjoy the ride.
See? What's left of that bridge over there? I heard about it being destroyed. Do you know if that was also my son's doing?
No, I'm pretty sure he had nothing to do with that one.
Well, I fear they will find a way to blame it on us anyway. We'll continue on this way. I'm going to look for some herbs to give you. See the wolves over there feasting on that horse? Brutality and beauty are both all around us. Yet so often we're unable to see past our own grievances. This is what I try to teach my son.
Yeah! Go on, get at it!
Good. There was no need to harm them. We can talk if you want, Mr. Morgan. But don't feel like you have to.
Are you all right back there?
Why are you riding off like that?
So, you were saying?
It's a beautiful ride ahead if you need some time to think.
How much you know about Dutch?
A little. Mostly what Charles told me.
For years, he was the best man I knew. But he's been unraveling for some time now, and I ain't sure there's any going back at this point.
It took a long time for me to learn that you could never change a person. We only become more who we really are. Perhaps you see that with him. Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here. You see that with him, just as I see it with my son.
Dutch has got this crazy plan that If we create enough noise and chaos, we'll be able to escape and go somewhere far away where no one will find us. I worry a lot of folks are gonna get caught in the crossfire, including Eagle Flies.
So what can we do?
I ain't quite sure. Just wanted you to know the situation.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought. Be careful. There are some steep turns up ahead, but the views are beautiful from up here.
You know, I had a son once, years ago. Don't talk about him much.
Oh, what was his name?
Isaac. His mother, Eliza, was a waitress I met. When she got pregnant, she knew who I was, what my life was. I didn't want to promise nothing I couldn't keep, but I said I'd do right by them. Every few months,
Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. We can talk more about this later. Wait there. I'll put these in your saddlebag. Mix these together. It tastes awful, but it'll help to keep your strength up. All right, let's go. It's not much further now. So you were saying,
every few months, I'd stop by there for a few days. He was such a good kid. She was too, I guess. Just a kid, 19.
What happened?
I got there one day and saw two crosses outside. I knew right away. Turned out some bastards had come through. Robbed them. Shot them dead. And offered $10. Hardened me, feeling that kind of pain. But I know now that you don't get to live a bad life and have good things happen to you.
I think you're being hard on yourself.
Maybe. All I can do now is try and make some things right. I appreciate the herbs, but I think it's gonna take more than that. I saw a doctor and he says I'm in a pretty bad way.
I'm sorry to hear that.
This situation we're in, me, Dutch, and the others, I don't know how long I got, but some of them, they still got a chance to have a life. I just think if I could give them that, then maybe this ain't all for nothing.
I think there is much you can still do, Mr. Morgan. It's just up ahead. What's happened?
No!
It can't be.
No! They've destroyed everything!
I need to find the Chinupa. Who would do this?
Someone who wanted to enrage you.
Help me. Please. The Tanupa is gone.
Of course. What is it?
A ceremonial pipe. There must be some clues to what happened here.
There's some whiskey here.
Okay. Let me give this some more thought. Thank you, Mr. Morgan. This is a place of peace.
Sure looks like they was doing some drinking.
I see no end to any of this. More over here.
There's some logs here they must have used as kindling.
An empty bottle of whiskey.
Well, if they drank all that, they couldn't have gotten too far.
Yeah, well, still no sign of the Tanupa.
Bastards are having a party up here.
Look there. Smoke. Do you have any binoculars? Oh, there they are. These brave men. Some of Colonel Favor's men. They must have been the ones who did this.
Are you surprised this happened?
Not at all. But... I hope we were past this.
Well, you got land they want. Land with oil.
They moved us here. They've taken everything we had. I signed 3 treaties myself, and they've broken each one. Now they've taken the last hope.
Favors was trying to get him transferred. I don't like him much.
He always seemed like a decent enough fella to me.
Exactly. That's the problem. Monroe went to West Point. Favors never made it.
Yeah. I'm sure. Engines. Just seems so... I'm silly, though.
I know. Who wants to fight them? Who cares? My uncle married an Indian anyway. She seemed nice enough.
An Indian?
What's that? Fellas! Over here. Take your hands off, man.
I'm gonna pull your head off.
Please tell me you found it.
Here. I got your things, I think.
Yes. Thank you.
I'm very sorry about this.
Even sacred things are only things. People, the heart, matter more. Was anyone hurt?
Yes.
It's a bad business. I should not have let you do this for me. But perhaps it will stop a bigger massacre. With these, maybe I can calm my people. Maybe I can calm my son.
I hope so.
Thank you. Take those herbs I gave you, please. And most of all, I hope you can find peace within yourself.
He's a man who, not so long ago, I would have found weak and pathetic. Now I see as wise and thoughtful and sensible. I would love to help him. Or at least stop Dutch pushing his son to do something real stupid.
a while, girl. Yep.
Okay. Jesus, what the hell is this?
Mr. Morgan!